Hey, thanks for tuning in to this specific topic, which I'm going to talk about today. And that is, are you ready? Are you think you ready for war part three? You know what I'm saying? Oh, I know. I'm reaching. Man, no the hell I ain't. Let me tell you something, man. And this is going to be the truth. You know, they say this is a biological weapon. Iranian, Russian, and Chinese officials saying that, which you can see right here. You know what I'm saying? They're saying that this is a biological weapon. But where it come from, though? Wuhan, China, right? So, my thoughts and my calculations from this is basically just telling me that you just declared war on the people. There's thousands of people that's died from this illness, from this biological weapon. You know what I'm saying? And from my looks of it, you know, they wanted to do this. You know what I'm saying? And again, you know what I'm saying, for those who looked at my other videos, especially when it come down to the Georgia Guidestones, and when it come down to my whole series of Are You Think You Ready For War, the whole series, I was telling y'all somewhat of this matter, but the thing about it is, it's more to go down a rabbit hole. It's more that's down a rabbit hole. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's more to it. And it's a biological weapon. Actually, it's one. This is used for multiple purposes, y'all. This is used for multiple purposes. Now, besides that fact, I'm just going to tell y'all that watch in about like a year or two, China is going to, people going to question China. Best believe that I smell a war going on. I smell a war. Okay, let me bring y'all back to 1918 right quick. Over there when they said that this, when they had an epidemic of the flu. Right after that flu, they had a war. Now, I want y'all to do y'all research and find out the proof that this is the first attack. And while everybody distracted and watching TV, you know what I'm saying, and getting your mind away from what's really going on, they've been putting these stunts behind your back. You know what I'm saying? And I think on one of my videos when I said that, oh, you think you're ready for war, whether it was what part one or part two, I said that America is not ready. I said they would not be ready. And guess what happened? Y'all weren't ready. And I'm going to break this down too. I don't sit here behind this camera and tell y'all no bullshit. Everything that I look up, best believe it be for sure. Best believe it be evident in the future. Because time repeats itself, y'all. And if y'all don't get the pattern of this, I don't know what to say for you, man. I don't know what to say. But what I'm telling you is that they just declared war on us. And let me tell you another thing. You know what this agenda was a part of? You know what this is a part of? You know what this is ushering in? Let me tell you what this ushering in. This ushering in a cashless society. Now, what I'm about to tell you, it's going to be right on fact. And I want you to do your research and come back to my page. Yeah, and then come back to my page and tell me, was I right? Now, the thing is, they're trying to get rid of paper. They're trying to get rid of the paper money. They're trying to find each and every way to get rid of the paper money. And they're like, okay, you know coronavirus can be spread on a piece of paper. You know somebody can sneeze on a, on some money, then you know the coronavirus is on the money. You know what I'm saying? So what was going to happen is, you know what I'm saying, they're going to burn up the old money that we've been spending. And the reason why Trump is going to allow this little loan, which he took out to give us this little $1 trillion, which is called a stimulus package, this is to reboost the paper. So the paper, let me tell you something about this. This is what they don't tell you. Every time when the presidents take a loan or an agenda or an administration take out a loan just to give to the American people, don't you know the value of that money goes down? Okay?
Look
at TV. This, you see that the restaurants, all you gotta do is to tell them the information on your card and they come right at your door. Trust me, I tried it. You know what I'm saying? You don't even have to give them cash no more. You know what I'm saying? Like, they won't even accept cash. I tried to deliver me some daggone pizza from Little Caesars because I used to go to Little Caesars, buy my pizza because I don't want to buy that high-end pizza from other places. But anyway, you know what I'm saying? I tried to order me some Little Caesars. They won't even sell paper. They won't even sell money. They asked me for my card information. I didn't buy it, but they asked me for my card information and stuff like that. Then I asked, do y'all take money? I called up there and I said, do y'all take money? They said, no. So I was like, dang. So what they doing is they rehearsing this shit and see how it's going to run. See how a cashless society going to run. See, y'all don't, man, I'm trying to tell y'all, man, y'all open up, man. Open up your eyes and see what's around you. You know what I'm saying? Everything that they doing as a rehearsal. They doing as a rehearsal. And one thing that I like to point at, man, one thing I like to get to, y'all see that they trying to do Agenda 21. Y'all see it, man. Okay, let me point out the obvious. Crime is low. You know what I'm saying? Crime is low. Action has been low. It's a project, man. It's a project. Y'all don't understand that this is a project. But, this is a warning, man. This is to tell y'all that, again, it ain't, even though the disease is going out here, it is such thing as coronavirus and it is going out here rapidly, but y'all don't understand. This has been unleashed upon us for us to run towards a little doctor. And let me tell you something about this shit, man. Let me tell you something what they being paid to do. For those that say they don't have no symptoms of it, because coronavirus, I'm going to tell you something about coronavirus. Coronavirus, you're going to feel symptoms of coronavirus. Coronavirus ain't nothing to play with. Now, if you don't have no symptoms from coronavirus, and you go and get tested, why are they saying you have coronavirus? So, to me, I think it's a bigger agenda. But again, I think what they doing is they putting shitting in them needles. And if you see the medicine what inside them needles, what they treat you with, man, they ain't giving you shit. All they giving you is the same little vaccine what they give you for the flu. And then what they do, they put little nanobites. Then you are not going to see the nanobites in the formula itself. You're going to see the nanobite. The nanobites is in the needle. It's in the needle. It's the size of a rice grain. And the reason why they doing this, and the reason why they doing this without your permission, is because if they say, okay, we're going to put chips in everybody, just so everybody can have currency. You know what I'm saying? Man, motherfuckers ain't going to want to go. People is not going to want to go and get no chip in their daggone arm. No matter you got to be forced to or not, we just not going to conform to all that. So, yeah, they got to find a way to get you sick, and they got to find a way to get you tested, because this bring about fear. And let me tell you another thing. They couldn't do it at the right time. They couldn't do it at the right time when pollen season is coming and all this rain season coming. And they know that this is flu season. They know that. They know that this is allergen season. So if you be like, oh, like say it's like if you feel bad because you are allergen and you go get tested, they can say, oh, you got coronavirus. They can simply say you got coronavirus. Y'all don't see that this is an agenda, man. Y'all, man. Boy, this is an agenda, man. I swear to God, bro. I smell bullshit. I smell bullshit a mile away, man. But y'all keep on being tricked and deceived, though. I can't sit back here and talk all nice to y'all and say, well, y'all better look out. There's more than just whatever. No, man, I'm telling y'all today, going real, man, for real. This is what's been going on in front of your face, man. In front of your face. Come on, man. There's look online, there's a discussion about Cardi B and Idris Elba about being paid to say that you got coronavirus. Now, I understand Idris Elba's point about him just, you know what I'm saying, him open up and say he got coronavirus, but then again, you know what I'm saying, Cardi B and all of them, y'all in the same industry. You all entertainers. So if Cardi B gonna come out and say that shit, come on, man. Y'all know, man, come on now. The girl ain't gonna be saying that shit for no odd damn reason. She ain't gonna be saying that shit for no odd damn reason. She must know something. That, man, I'm trying to tell you, y'all wake up, man, because what they trying to do, man, they trying to convince you that, oh, everybody need to get the vaccine and shit like that. Man, if you don't have no symptoms, don't even go, man. Dead ass for real. If you don't have no symptoms, don't go. They'll be stupid. Because one thing they're going to do, they're going to try to lie to you. And then the thing about that is, about testing, you know what I'm saying? They said that they're going to come up with something. They're going to send a test to your mailbox. And then you're going to end up having to be tested. You know what I'm saying? They let you know if you negative or let you know if you negative or positive of coronavirus. You know what I'm saying? And they saying based on your results, and if you don't get treated, you won't be able to get no jobs, and you won't be able to get the shit that you normally would get before all this shit happened. You know what I'm saying? That's not right. Because if I don't feel no symptoms, and if y'all tell the motherfuckers to stay home, and if I don't conform to no damn test, I don't have to conform to no damn test. So you mean to tell me I'm not going to get no job? Man, fuck y'all. Y'all fuck off in y'all agenda, man. For real, man. Get the hell out of here. That's not going to succeed. Trust me, that's not going to succeed. Best believe that, man. For real, the smoke is all in y'all face now. Now, you know what I'm saying? Time's going to be hard. Things is not going to be the same, man. It might go to somewhat of a norm, But it ain't gonna, man, life ain't never gonna be the same after this. Dead ass for real, man. And let you know, man, I got laid off my job because of this bullshit. Now I gotta figure out what the fuck I gotta do. You know what I'm saying? I had plans for my page and all that, man. Dead for real. Now I got a setback. You know what I'm saying? Now I gotta start back. Now I gotta see, can I do this from scratch? This shit fucked up, man. It's messed up, man. But it's more coming, y'all. This ain't nothing but a test. This is nothing but a test, y'all. For some other shit. And I think this is about time that they gonna bring it. Somebody gonna go to war with China, man. I'm feeling this in the air, man. I'm feeling this in the air. Somebody about to go to war with China, man. Because every time when a disease like this break out, it always got to be in the Middle East and it always got to be in China. Like, and let me speak about another thing, though. You know what I'm saying? I ain't for Trump. You know what I'm saying? I ain't against Trump. But when that motherfucker told y'all to, no, not y'all, but what he told the, but when he told the Congress that they got to close our borders to the Chinese motherfuckers, not to say that, y'all. I'm sorry. I do have kinfolk that's Chinese, so I'm not racist toward Chinese. This is my grandma, y'all. I'm sorry, y'all. I'm sorry. But other than that, when Trump closed the door, when he wanted to close the door to the Chinese to prevent this, guess what y'all were doing? Oh, Trump is a racist. Oh, Trump is this. Oh, Trump is that. And that and that and that and that. When that man just tried to save us, man. When that man just tried to prevent this from going on. You see? Y'all so motherfucking brainwashed, man. Y'all think that. And it's so much I can say about Trump in a good way that he do help out. You know what I'm saying? But what y'all do, y'all gonna see blame in Trump because Trump is not likable in the black neighborhood and stuff like that. But if I start naming some positive shit that he done, like, remember, I'm not for Trump and I'm not against Trump. I'm just speaking facts. But ever since he been in office, I ain't gonna lie, ever since he been in office, motherfuckers have been getting jobs. People have been getting jobs. But you can't say that to everybody. But you can't say that Trump didn't want to ban the Chinese from coming over here because he knew what was going on. But instead, y'all were like, man, Trump being a racist, man. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. But if it was Obama and he said, close China, you know what I'm saying? Make sure, you know what I'm saying, to ban the airports from flying over here, y'all would have been on his side. And I'm dead for real about that. Y'all know that. But just to end this, because it's coming on 20 minutes, and you know I don't keep my videos that long. This is war, y'all. This is war. Y'all might not think it's war, but I smell it coming. Now, I don't really have perspective about this shit. But what I'm going to say is this. Man, y'all say washing your hands. Y'all say covering up your mouth. Y'all say doing the 6 feet thing. Because this coronavirus is real out here. It's real. But I think it's blown up. It's a little blown up. But it's real, though. You know what I'm saying? But I'm just telling y'all to be careful, man. Be careful out here, man. And get ready, y'all. Get ready because this ain't gonna be just coronavirus. Oh, it's another wave coming. It's something else coming. Best believe that. There's something else coming. If you ain't ready, you better get ready. Because this is a sign right here to get you ready right here. If this don't get you ready, I don't know what else will. Let this coronavirus set you straight. Get your mind thinking. Let this coronavirus get you on your feet. For those who got money and for those that like to just spend money out of the willy-nilly, yeah, say your shit. Say your shit. And better yet, here's another perspective. This perspective is, if you got money, paper money, this right here, this is not going to last. Okay? Transmit this into a debit card. Trust me. Because say bye-bye to this. This is going to be no more. Okay? This is going to be no more. Put everything on a debit card. You know where they put the chips inside your... You know what they put the chips inside your daggone card for? You know why? To replace this shit. To replace this. It's just getting you prepared, man. So get prepared. Y'all ain't seen nothing yet, man. But y'all is going to see it. I believe this generation is going to see some shit. You know? Oh, and everybody running to their Bibles. Everybody running and say, oh, this is prophecy and stuff like that. Man, this is part one. This is just the beginning, baby. You ain't seen nothing. This is just the beginning of the show. Understand this. We in the fifth seal of Revelation. We in the fifth seal. Just for y'all who want to know where you at in the Bible, you want to know where you at? You on the fifth seal. Read about the fifth seal in Revelation. You is on the fifth seal. There's a lot more to come. Let this event be the event that you get prepared. Dead for real. I want to give you more, but what much I can explain. But just tell you to get prepared, man. If you ain't had a relationship with God, you might as well get one right now. Because it's about to get hard. It's about to get hard, y'all. But I'm going to let that be it, man. All right, man. I hope y'all like and subscribe. Please like and subscribe because I'm going to be giving y'all more content. And I'm sorry for not giving this video right away. Because for one, you know what I'm saying? Like, I got to live my life too. I'm living my life too, you know? So I'm getting things in order too, you know? Like I said, man, I don't lost my job. Now I got to figure out what the hell I got to do. You know what I'm saying? To provide for my family because this, man, I'm trying to tell you, man, this been a blow, man. This been a heavy blow. You know what I'm saying? And it's a good thing I got money saved, you know? But the same thing that I'm saying, it applies to me too. I got to get prepared. I got to transfer all this into a card, you know? But with that said, man, peace and love yourself. This has been Jay Fury. This is Fury Perspective, man. I hope y'all be good out there. Y'all recover for those who caught the COVID-19, the coronavirus, man. I hope you recover, man. I hope you get better and return to what you need to do, you know what I'm saying, in life, because I understand that sometimes things can hit you out of nowhere. You know what I'm saying? So, again, like and subscribe, and make sure you hit that bell so you can get all these notifications, man. But with that said, oh, that's another thing. That's another thing. It's another thing. You fear is life. My bad, y'all. I'm scratching my eyes and shit like that. I got pollen allergies. That's the reason why I got this on, because of pollen allergies and stuff like that. I be having that with my mouth, but other than that, I would like to say, basically, man, just, fear is life. It's about to start right back up. I'm about to create me another page. It's like, I've been telling y'all about to create me another page. I'm about to do this and I'm about to do that. Right now, it's a lot of things going on, you know what I'm saying? A lot of things going on. So, what I'm going to be trying to do is, hopefully, things get back in touch so I can really, like, give y'all some more content other than me sitting behind this phone giving y'all these topics and stuff like that. When I can sit here and you can explore with me and figure out what I do on a daily basis, you know what I'm saying? Because I don't be stuck in this house all day. I don't be stuck in this room all day. I actually have a life. So, I been wanting to show y'all that, but I was like, man, I don't even think I got the right counts for all this shit. You know what I'm saying? Because I'm not going to show y'all everything from this phone. Nah. So, I've been trying to upgrade in my cameras and stuff like that. So, y'all just hang on with me and stuff like that. But, I just been wanting to say that. So, if y'all been fucking with me for the longest, man, y'all make sure y'all share my videos and make sure the subscriber count get higher. And please like and subscribe for the third time. So, with that said, man, I'm out.